Well, in fact, the serum is one in a row of similar serums. Ну, вот существует целый ряд аналогичных теорем. Maybe this one is one of the most beautiful ones. I call this theorem, I don't know how to say it in English, in a proper way. Теорема об ужасных многоугольниках. This is how I call it. Because whatever polygon A, B, C, and these are its ears. Okay. So, ужасных многоугольниках. And there are quite a number of theorems of this sort. For example, one simple theorem is if you take a parallelogram and draw squares on its sides, then what do we do then?
The centers of the squares.
Yes. The centers of the squares or of the square. I think this theorem, or maybe its generalization, a theorem of the Avoxinian, is called another one of the theorem. I'm not sure that exactly this one, maybe a little bit more general. But anyway. Okay, I suggest you to prove this theorem. You can use something that we did yesterday. It is not. It must be doable. You must be able to do it.
Conjecture?
Yes.
Good. This doesn't work. So you can use, as I said, you can use projection if the parallel projection, if the problem is a file, if the other shape is a finite. If it uses only the objects that are preserved under projection, если задача использует только такие объекты и факты, которые сохраняются при параллельной проекции, тогда да. But these squares after projection are no longer squares, so this is not possible.
But we have
Yes.
We had a problem about two squares. Yes. So here we have two pairs of squares. Yes, of course. Yes. We just think how what to do to reduce this problem to the one of our two squares. Let's take any quadrilateral, not a parallelogram, but an arbitrary quadrilateral, and do the same. Again, squares, centers, and what can you say? I just want this is like a yeah, like a sort of a discovery. Yeah, what can you say about maybe you have to draw several? Можно применить нашу теорему. triangle, apply the theorem to this triangle, and we then we know that this triangle is right isosceles triangle. Then we do the same for the next triangle, this one. And we know that this triangle is also right isosceles triangle. So two right isosceles triangles put together make a bigger right isosceles triangle, half a square. And then the fourth one, and the third one, and the fourth one, and together they make a square. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay, but what about the arbitrary code?